Yes, I'll start. I just give your presence by like comment. My name is Kishore Pingalkar. I worked more than 30 years in auto industry, a company called Automotive Research Association of India. I'm having huge experience and interacted with more than 200 industry people during my service scenario. Service period in 2015 onwards, I started my own activity. Because of COVID-19, most of the people are in the house. I thought that I'll share my views. This is especially my views for the business sustainability after COVID-19 lockdown opening. This lockdown, don't think that it is a problematic situation for us. Definitely we'll come out of that. And I'll just share the information in English as well as Hindi as well as Marathi. It will be the mix. लॉकडाऊनच्या इफेक्टमुळे आपल्याला काहीच खरं फरक पडणार नाही, पण इंडस्ट्री सेगमेंटमध्ये जर विचार केला तर ह्याचा खरोखर खूप फरक पडणार आहे. आपल्या नीड्स ज्या आहेत, ते नीड्स जे आपण थोड्या रेस्ट्रिक्ट केल्या आणि लिमिटेड नेचरमध्ये आणल्या, तर ह्या लॉकडाऊनचा फरक न पडता आपण डेफिनेटली जम्प 1-1.5 वर्षामध्ये चांगल्या पद्धतीने घेऊ शकतो. वी कॅन टेक दिस डेफिनेटली जम्प विद इन अ इयर ऑफ स्पॅन. दिस इज अ लाईक अ one step we have to come back. If you ask me, where spirit is very good for the people to do thinking on their business, how they can plan the future business and how can they do that. If you ask me, I'll segregate the businesses, the people who are already working on the businesses in different sectors. Auto sector is there, IT sector is there, agriculture sector is there. Irrespective of sector, the people who are doing the businesses, people who have started the businesses is definitely important for us. The people who have started the businesses 15 years back, the people who have started back, the people who have started the businesses 5 years back. If you differentiate these people, definitely the impact will be more for the people who have started a business 5 years back. Because definitely the return on investment what they have put in their business, irrespective of agri sector, IT sector, service sector, dealership or these all patterns. The 5 years back, the people who already invested their money by taking the loan from the bank as well as by putting the till date, their return on investment is not started at. That's why for these people, it's very important how they can come out of this during this period. I am of the opinion that the people who have started the businesses 5 years back, they should be more careful. Because this lockdown period, whatever 1 month, 2 months, and maybe after 2 months we may require 3 to 4 months to start our businesses. So around 6 month period, you definitely, it's very difficult for us, the people who have started the business 5 years back. If you see the people who have started at 10 years back, definitely their investment and capex, definitely they must have earned from their businesses. The people who have started the businesses before 15 years back, I'm confident their capex investment has come out of that, and their investment, present investment, is on the working capital, and they may require the labor payment or whatever these infrastructures. So for them, definitely impact is there, but it is not whatever the people who have started the business 5 years back. It is not equal to the amount of that. The people 5 years back has to think properly, and if you ask me, I started business at the age of 52 years. Whatever the money I was having, I put after getting the VRS or in the business. And like me, there are industry people are there, so many people are there. They invested their money in the trading or acquiring some unit or as well as some with the import people, some foreign people, they are already joint ventures, and they are working on that. The people who already made the joint venture with the foreign companies, definitely they are having very big impact. Do you agree this? I am confident everyone will agree that. The people who are having the joint venture with European countries, the people who are having the joint venture with Asian countries, they are also having a very tough time, because whatever the money they are shared with these people, that is, it will get blocked for more than 5-6 months. And the same scenario is for the trader as well as the sectors who are working in present scenario. I feel that the people, the entrepreneurs who have started as startups, are young engineers also started their startup as well as their innovations 2 years, 3 years back. They should also think properly now, because you are expecting a business income 10, 15, 20, 30 lakhs from the businesses. So for to earn the business income, you must do the business more than 3 crores of rupees, worth of rupees. In a year, 30 lakhs income is that, then your labor payment is that, goes out of that. Similarly, infrastructure is whatever you are maintain it, you have to pay for that. So we have to see that the startups or the young engineers, it should not hamper to them. The growth should not get hampered. The young engineers should think twice, thrice, because 3, 4, 5, 6 months is very huge period. Government is supporting for the MSMEs, they will support for the industry people. But the people who have started startup, as well as traders, as well as these people, their registration process is difficult. The registration process, they are registered, government will never come to know what type of registration they have done it. So government may not support to the people who are having the turnover of 3 crore, 5 crore, up to 10 crores. That's my personal experience. But traders, government will support definitely for the farmers. Government will definitely support for the big joint ventures. Government will support, but what about the small people? This is very big. Young engineers are there. Or veterans who have started the business after 54, 55 age, they are also very big in numbers. So we have to see that. But if you see that business will run, the people are having very good mind. If you cross this 6 month period, definitely you can cross the hurdles in the life. I am confident we people are there. We are thinkers. We always take active our involvement after thinking much more on what we are doing. So if you ask me, the people who have started business 5 years back, return on investment has not yet started for them. It's a tough task to them. The people who have started, because everyone will understand the present scenario is not that you will get the 55% or 45% profit. The present scenario is that irrespective of business sector, your profit is 35%. Where intrinsic value is not there, so computer people getting more, but hardly 2-3% people may be in that sector, but most of the 97 sector people are there, they are earning 35% profit. Out of their profit, they are investing on the labor, they are investing on the rent, they are investing on this. So it's difficult for these people to sustain. The lockdown period, is, or the rethinking on what, how we can enhance our business after 4-5 months. Once lockdown will open, you don't expect that you will get a big orders. Orders will not be there. It will take 2-3 months by time. Our money is already invested. Money, the people are not giving the money. After 1 or 2 months time, when the business will start, the people will start giving the money back. And they will not give the money, whatever they are having now. They will not give the money immediately. They will take also 1 to 2 months above that. Do you agree this? I am confident for the people like us, who is having turnover of 10 crores, who is having turnover of 5 crores in the traders, as well as the 10 crores in MSMEs, it's very difficult task. Basically, I'm thinking how we can approach to the government or PMO Indians. Whether anyone can, definitely whatever we are paying the labor payment, whether government will give us some 50% or 25% of that to the labor payment to us, we have to think on that. Second thing, whatever the we are giving the rent for the industry, whether the rent will be as per ATD or income tax and these things, they are giving 30% depreciation. So same amount, if they extend it for the rent, what we are paying for the 3 months period, definitely that will be good support. I am of the opinion that. Similarly, not only 3 months, after lockdown, a 2 months period, we may have to do that. So around 5-6 months period will be there. So we expect government to support us. I am just started a week back, I already shared this information on my FB live. I am thinking that we should approach to the PMO. Yeah, I am the co-convener of Pune Auto Expo. We are interacted with big joint companies also, as well as small companies also. I noticed that people, they, when the expenditure is there, the people is having a lot of fear. They don't want to invest in this expo as well as this. That's what I noticed. When we approach to big joint, they also think that why to expenditure? Now to curtail expenditure will be the main parameter for the future. Your expenditure should be a 10 to 15% of that. Your rent income or labor payment should be 35% of that. Balance 50 out of 100, 15% goes here, balance 50% in your hand. So I am of the opinion all this industry as well as these people should think on this, and we should see how we can make a sustainable business. My views, especially for the young engineers, especially for the veterans who have started above 50-55, not for the people who have already established their business 10 years or 15 years back. Definitely this will be the hard workship for the people who have started business 5 years back. What you say? Any questions you can raise? We can start up definitely thinking on this particular parameter. My business, I am having the Tejman Associate Group. We are working, we are supporting to the auto sectors. More than 600 customers are there, automobile shop owners as well as retailers. These people, we are giving services to them. I am the trader for the one of the oil company. I am the trader for the Mahindra Group. I am the trader for the Lumax Group. We are already given the material to the people. We are expecting definitely payment from them. Definitely it will get stuck up. I am confident they will pay it. But after the opening lockdown, 1 to 2 months, they are not given. But I am able to sustain this particular time period because I am veteran. Second thing, if anyone is having business, the person liability, whatever he is having from the house as well as from the car and these things, if he is having liability, then also it becomes difficult for him. If he is not having the liability, then the person can sustain. So these are important parameters we have to think on this. This is what my particular views, how the business can be sustained in the particular scenario, how this future will be there. Definitely it is said that the people, winner always never lose, they always win. The entrepreneurs, as having that consciousness, they entered into business to win the situation. We have to cross this particular situation, we have to win. And for winning, these hurdles we have to cross. आपल्या सगळ्यांना याच्याबद्दल पूर्ण अंदाज आहेच आहे. थोडा टफ पिरियड आहे, आपण याच्यातनं सस्टेन करू शकलो तर डेफिनेटली वी कॅन रीच टू द मून. मी तर डेफिनेटली माझे इन्व्हेस्टमेंट, माझे रिटर्न्स, रिटर्न ऑन इन्व्हेस्टमेंट ह्या 2-3 महिन्याच्या पिरियडमध्ये जे आहे त्याचासुद्धा विचार करणार नाही आहे. मी माझ्या लेबरला पूर्ण सपोर्ट करणार आहे. लेबर रिटर्न राहिलं तर आपला पुढल्या गोष्टी सगळ्या, जसं मोदी सरकारसुद्धा म्हणतं की लॉकडाऊनमुळं इकॉनॉमी बाद में पहिले म्हणजे माणसाचं आयुष्य. सो आय एम ऑल्सो थिंकिंग इन द सेम पॅटर्न. आय सॅल्यूट टू द इंडियन एव्हरी बिझनेसमन इरेस्पेक्ट ऑफ हिज एरिया ऑफ बिझनेस. पण ह्या महत्त्वाच्या गोष्टी आहेत बिझनेस सेक्टरमध्ये. मी 2 स्प्रेड आउट केलं आहे तुम्हाला, 5 वर्ष 10 वर्ष 15 वर्ष. या पिरियडमध्ये 15 वर्षाच्या वर जे आहेत त्यांचं ऑलरेडी सेटल झालेले बिझनेस आहेत. जे 10 वर्षाच्या वरचे आहेत त्या लोकांचे सेटल झालेले नाही, जस्ट झालेले असतात. त्यांना लेबर आणि मॅनपॉवर किंवा ज्या ठिकाणी बिझनेस करतात त्याची लायबिलिटी असते. जे 5 वर्षाचे झालेले आहेत त्यांना हा डिफिकल्ट पिरियड आहे. या डिफिकल्ट पिरियडमधनं समजा ते सस्टेन होऊ शकले तर बिझनेस सस्टेनेबिलिटी इम्पॉर्टंट. ट्रेडमध्ये एक इम्पॉर्टंट गोष्ट म्हणजे जेव्हा तुम्ही, दुसरी एक गोष्ट माझ्या लक्षात आली, इम्पोर्ट एक्सपोर्ट जे म्हणतात, इम्पोर्ट एक्सपोर्टमध्ये तुम्ही फॉरेन कंपनीबरोबर जॉईंट व्हेंचर करतात. एखादा प्रॉडक्ट विकल्यानंतर तुम्हाला कमिशन बेसवर इथं तुम्हाला या ठिकाणी बिझनेस करायची परवानगी असते. पण कुठल्यासुद्धा ट्रेडमध्ये लेटर ऑफ क्रेडिट किंवा वायर ट्रान्सफर कुठलीही कंपनी ॲडव्हान्स देत नाहीच. तर तुम्ही एखाद्या फॉरेन कंपनीबरोबर टायअप केलं असेल तर त्या कंपनीला तर खरोखर हे मागचं वर्ष सोडून पुढचं अजून एक वर्ष तर त्यांना डिफिकल्ट आहे. तर इंटरनॅशनल नॉर्म्समध्ये जे मेडिएटर आहेत त्या लोकांना सुद्धा हा पिरियड फार कठीण पिरियड आहे. इंटरनॅशनल ट्रॅव्हल बंद होणार, इक्विपमेंटची कार्गो मुवमेंट बंद होणार, फ्रेट कॉस्ट एकदमच वेळच्यावेळी चेंज होईल त्याची कोणाला आता खात्री नाही आहे. दुसरं गोष्ट, डिलिव्हरी पिरियड कोणीसुद्धा कमिटमेंट करू शकणार नाही. तर तुम्हाला लेटर ऑफ क्रेडिट जर केली तर डेफिनेटली तुम्हाला इन्व्हेस्टमेंट आता तुम्हाला ठेवावं लागेल. वायर ट्रान्सफर करून कोणीही बिझनेस करणार नाही. आम्ही आता नाशिकच्या एका पार्टीबरोबर ग्रेपसाठी, एक्सपोर्टसाठी डिस्कशन करत होतो तर त्यांनी ग्रेप्सचा ऑर्डर मिळालेली होल्ड झालेली, सध्याच्या तशी आता ऑर्डर त्यांच्या हातात आहे पण दे कॅनॉट एक्सपोर्ट इट. तर इंटरनॅशनल ट्रान्सपोर्टमध्ये खरोखर खूप अवघड आहे. माझ्या दृष्टिकोनातनं हे 2-3 बिझनेसेस जर पाहिले तर भारताच्या फक्त म्हणजे आपल्या जुन्या पद्धतीमध्ये जसं म्हणायचे नीचे दुकान उपर मकान, हे सध्या बिझनेसेस पुढे चांगले चालू शकतील. आपला माझं ऑफिस पुण्यामध्ये, माझं एक ऑफिस दुबईमध्ये, माझं एक ऑफिस तेहरानमध्ये, असं म्हणणाऱ्यांना खरोखर पुढे वाव थोडा कमी मिळू शकेल. कारण इंटरनॅशनल नॉर्म्स प्रत्येक कंट्रीचे वेगवेगळे होऊ शकतील असं एक प्रिडिक्शन आहे. कारण ट्रॅव्हल नॉर्म्स स्टॉप झाले तर आपल्याला इक्विपमेंटसुद्धा शिपमेंटचा प्रॉब्लेम्स आहेत. हे 1-2 वर्षापुढचा पिरियड आहे. म्हणजे मी असं म्हणत नाही की हा परमनंट राहील. This will be definitely will get change, but we have to think on this particular parameter also. Ki if any trader, mediator who is Indian agent of any foreign companies, definitely he will face a lot of troubles. Maje swatache aata eka Chinese company varobar discussion hona, ami tyanche sudha product he kele hote pan ami hold kele, ami ti product डिस्पॅच करू नका म्हणून त्यांना सांगितलं आणि लेटर ऑफ क्रेडिटसुद्धा आम्ही कॅन्सल केले. हा इंटरनॅशनल नॉर्म्समधला हा जो पॅरामीटर आहे हा सगळ्यांना विचारात करण्यासारखा आहे. तर माझ्या दृष्टिकोनातनं थोडक्यात येस, मला क्वेश्चन आलेला आहे, शॅल वी मॉडिफाय अवर मार्केटिंग स्ट्रॅटेजी इन दिस सिच्युएशन. मार्केटिंग स्ट्रॅटेजी सिच्युएशनमध्ये डिफाईन करायची तर तुम्ही लोकल लेवलला करू शकता का बाहेरच्या लेवलला करू शकता, हा एक इम्पॉर्टंट पॅरामीटर. तुम्ही जर पाहिलं US हाय क्वालिटी हाय रेट्स आहेत, चायनामध्ये लो क्वालिटी लो रेट्समध्ये मिळतात, पण इंडियामध्येच एक अशी कंडिशन आहे की हाय क्वालिटी एव्हरीवन वॉन्टेड अ प्रॉडक्ट ऑफ हाय क्वालिटी विथ लोअर रेट. मार्केटिंग स्ट्रॅटेजी तुम्ही जर ह्या कंडिशनमध्ये जर ठरवायचं झालं तर लोएस्ट रेटमध्ये तुम्ही कुठपण सस्टेन होता एक फार इम्पॉर्टंट आहे. सध्याच्या अनएम्प्लॉयमेंटमुळं सध्याच्या स्मार्टनेस इंजिनियर्स आपले खूप स्मार्ट आहेत, इंडियन यंग इंजिनियर्स आर व्हेरी इनोव्हेटिव्स, त्यांनी त्यांची इंटेलेक्च्युअल लेवल इतकी चांगली आहे की त्यांचं इनोव्हेशन असल्यामुळं त्यांचे प्राईस रेट फक्त सुद्धा कमी होतात. तर आपण क्वालिटीवर एक चांगला कॉन्शियसनेस ठेवून प्राईस मार्जिन कमी करू शकलो तर आपला बिझनेस ऑपॉर्च्युनिटीसुद्धा आहे. फक्त प्रॉफिट मार्जिन तुम्हाला 55% ऐवजी 35% किंवा 25% द्यावं लागतं. आत्ताच्या सध्याच्या कंडिशनमध्ये तुम्ही समजा इफ यू आर टेकिंग लोन फ्रॉम बँक, तुम्हाला 10% बँकेचे द्यावं लागतातच. तुम्हाला मिळणाऱ्या इन्कमच्या 10% तुमची इन्व्हेस्टमेंट ही लेबर किंवा ह्या कॉस्टमध्ये जाते, तर त्याच्यामुळे 20-25% ही तुमची ऑप्शनल कॉस्ट झाली. तुम्हाला 10% कॉस्ट ही प्रॉफिटमध्ये तुम्हाला ठेवली तर तुम्ही वर्षामध्ये 5 crore टर्न ओवर केला तर यू विल अर्न अराउंड 40-50 lakhs. त्याच्यामधून तुमचे एक्सपेंडिचर मायनस केले तर 10-20 lakhs रुपीज जास्तीत जास्त तुम्ही अर्न करू शकता. तर माझं ह्या बिझनेसमध्ये पाहायचा एक दृष्टिकोन असा आहे, 5 crore टर्न ओवर करणं हे सोपी गोष्ट नाही आहे. म्हणून MSME ज्या मशीन इन्व्हेस्टमेंट करतात त्यांना मशीनचं कॅपिटल डिप्रिशिएशन हे इन्व्हेस्टमेंट करून त्या मशीनचा त्या पद्धतीनं आउटपुट मिळणं फार अवघड आहे. सर्व्हिस इंडस्ट्रीला तुम्ही जास्तीत जास्त क्वालिटी लोक क्वांटिटी लोकांपुढे अप्रोच झाला तर डेफिनेटली तुम्हाला सपोर्ट मिळू शकतो. पण क्वांटिटी बिझनेस करायला तुम्हाला डिजिटल मीडियाचा खूप चांगला वापर करावा लागतो आणि डिजिटल मीडियाचा वापर करणं ह्याचा वापर चांगल्या पद्धतीने केला तर तुम्ही क्वांटिटी बिझनेस करू शकता. तर बिझनेस सस्टेनेबिलिटीमध्ये क्वालिटी प्रॉडक्टला आणि क्वांटिटी प्रॉडक्टला ह्या दोन ह्याच्यामध्ये डिफरन्शिएट केलं तर क्वालिटी प्रॉडक्टचा क्वालिटी इम्प्रूव्हमेंटसाठी यंग इंजिनियरचा फायदा घेऊन आपण जर चांगलं करू शकलो त्यांना अपॉर्च्युनिटी कर देऊन तर क्वालिटी प्रॉडक्ट विथ लोएस्ट कॉस्ट देन यू कॅन डेफिनेटली सस्टेन. पण तीसुद्धा तुमची 30-32% प्रॉफिटमध्ये पाहिजे. 30% प्रॉफिट प्रत्येकाला हाय प्राईस पाहिजे असते, प्रत्येकाला हाय प्रॉफिट पाहिजे असतो, ते सोडून द्या. मी या मताचा आहे तुमच्या जो कार जी सध्या आहे ती कार मेंटेन करा, सध्या जे घर आहे ते मेंटेन करा, तेवढंच हे ठेवून त्याच्या पुढचा प्रॉफिटचा न विचार करता यू विल गेट द प्रॉफिट विद इन आफ्टर 2 years ऑल्सो, बट गो सेफ, लिमिटेड इज एक्सपेक्ट लिमिटेड प्रॉफिट. अशा दृष्टीनं तुम्ही गेलात तर डेफिनेटली यू विल वर्क विथ सस्टेनेबल बिझनेस. आणि मला असं वाटतं की आपण ह्या COVID-19 डेफिनेटली बाहेर येऊत. आणि आपल्याला कुठलाही प्रश्न कधी असला तर माझा 9130016560 नंबर आहे. मी मार्केटमध्ये माझा पुणे सिटीबरोबर PCMC City ॲज वेल ॲज तुमचा शिरूर्स एरिया हा सगळा एरिया पर्टिक्युलर प्रॉडक्टसाठी माझ्याकडे आयडेंटिफाय झालेला आहे. मी पुण्यामध्ये पुणे ऑटोमोट डीलर असोसिएशन पाडाबरोबर संस्थाबरोबर काम करतो आम्ही, नंतर IIM इन्स्टिट्यूटबरोबर काम करतो. मी आमचे ॲडवायझरीमध्ये मिलिंद कांबळे सर आहेत जे दलित इंडस्ट्रियल चेंबरचे अध्यक्ष आहेत, तेसुद्धा आम्हाला वेळोवेळी मार्गदर्शन करतात. उद्देश हा डेफिनेटली सस्टेनेबल बिझनेससाठी आहे. मला क्वेश्चन आला आहे, इज इट ओके टू गिव क्लायंट अन आयडिया अबाउट अवर करंट बिझनेस सिच्युएशन. आवर करंट बिझनेस इज व्हेरी टफ I already shared with you. If you, our means industry sector, made, this question is particularly directed to me, or just can you clarify this? This is my business or our India business, you are saying that? That's what our current means, that's what I am in different ways. So everyone has to come out of that. That's what I want to say. I think I already talked from my side. If you are anyone is having question, you can share with me. We have to come out of this situation. That's what I want to say. Priyanka, shall we stop here because it's 11:29? Or what's any questions you can share with me? So thank you very much for your patience listening, and definitely we'll come very soon with a different topic and sharing our views. Okay. Now I received that question what she already asked. Is it okay to give client on any idea about our current business situation? It's she is saying about the my business. I already shared with you my business is of automotive sectors. Our investment is very big now in the auto sectors. We are already were expecting a return. We are expecting some all this material given to them in month of December, payment from their side. So in month of March or April, these people normally release the payment of the material which we are delivering in month of November, December. But in my business now, because of COVID-19, everyone has raised the hands and they will start giving the payment definitely in month of May or June. So there is a delay of 3-4 months period is there. Definitely I am the loser, losing the bank interest. The delayed payment cannot be because we cannot insist the people now. Because if you insist the people, then there are chances they may give it or may not give it. We have to think twice. Big companies are also there. If they decided not to give, what you can do? A big companies, there are a number of companies that my clients have already went to the court, they are fighting. So we have to understand the mutual situations. This situation is not for me. My situation as well as big corporate people's situation is same. Everyone is stuck up for the money. We should not insist them. If I can sustain, I will sustain. I had to sustain. I had to support them. I had to support. I will wait for a particular time to come. Because I already started business with thinking in mind that I will support to the society. Basically, if you ask me plainly, I do not have any liability from the home side, from the vehicle side, as well as for the, I'm little bit in. So that's why I shared with my people, irrespective of there is work or not, for the next 2-3 months, I'll try to give some percentage of amount toward the salary to you people. You are working with me because from last 1 and 2 years, definitely some percentage will be shared, irrespective of profit or loss. Because I am self-sustained. Now, how do you see the future of online business keeping operation cost low? Definitely, online business, it's difficult to say. In India, everyone wanted a product to in their hand. Online business is very difficult. The people who are, I have seen the Pune people, whether anyone is purchasing gold from online, no. anyone is purchasing clothes except my very few people are purchasing. But price parameter is very important. We always feel that we should get the feel of the product. That's why online businesses is very tough, because people wanted to see the face of the people. They wanted to just see the product in their hand. And that's what my opinion. I have seen the product, what our products are there, our market is also very big. But no one purchased from the online. No one wanted to go online because they feel that is not confidence level. Apart from there, the other products are there. Very few products like this mobile and these things, they can definitely go online. Groceries also, nowadays online is going on. But everyone cannot enter. The people who are having lot of money, they can enter into that. But small people, they cannot sustain. Because definitely their profit is also less in online business. Now I was having some 2 years back, some battery distributorship. Whenever the people wanted to purchase a battery, they were just looking to the product code and they were getting the prices from their mobile online, where the lowest price, and they were not purchasing from our site. That's why the people who are having the shops and these things, though these people doing on MRP base, they are the best people now. Online also, if you put that, MRP values are fixed. So MRP and DLP, these, the people who are working as a distributor, as well as DLP, as well as with the MRP price, they are the safest people now, I feel. But where there is no any values of the product mentioned on the your product, these people can do online business. The DLP, distributed list price, the price declared by MRP, hardly 5-6% variation may be there. That's what they can do, and other people. The MRP, lot of variation we have seen in Big Bazaar, as well as they do that because they think their business strategy is different totally. They wanted to earn a one day, they wanted to do the business for a day, next day a different policy. So their policies are different. That's what my study says. Any questions, or shall we close this today's session? And how do you feel that what way we can go ahead to interact you people, to get you more inputs, and how we can share that's information? So please share with us. My name is Kishore Pingalikar. I'm having 30 years experience. I was heading the purchase department as a general manager. We used to place more than 200 orders. Out of that, 10 to 20 orders are from the import side and from the local side. So the organization where I was working, it was research based. So the products are totally different. And now where I'm working is totally also different. I'm working in the area of consumer related products. I especially entered into this because I felt that if I would have started a different product where I was working in that area, there you have to knock the so many people and then only you will get a one or two orders. Their travel cost is here. Instead of that, quality quantity business is important. Thank you Priyanka, and we'll just hope that definitely I am confident you must have liked that, whatever shared information with you. Thank you very much.